design of beams. So myself, Quazi Syed Shujat Ali, currently working as assistant professor in civil engineering department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. At the end of the session, students will be able to design a laterally supported beam. Before starting the session, we'll see what is mean by beam. Beam is basically a structural member which is subjected to transverse loading. That is, the load will be perpendicular to the axis of the member or the axis of the particular beam. And because of this loading, it will produce bending moment as well as shear force. And we have to design a beam to resist this bending moment and shear force. There are various terminologies for beams. The first one is joist. What is mean by joist is nothing but it is also a beam, a closely spaced beam supporting floors or roofs of building but not supporting the other beams. It is a type of secondary beams. Girder is, what is mean by girder? Girder is a large beam used for supporting a number of joists. Purlins are used to carry roof loads in trusses. It is also a type of beam. Stringer, in building, beam supporting stair steps in bridges, a longitudinal beam supporting deck floor and supported by floor beam. In the case of staircase, the one beam which runs through the flight is nothing but the stringer. Floor beam, a major beam supporting other beams in a building, also the transverse beam in the bridge floor. Then we have spandrel beam, girt, lintels. Girt is nothing but a horizontal beam spanning the wall column of industrial building used to support wall coverings, is called as girt. And lintel beam, as you all know. Before starting the design of beams, we'll see various modes of failure. The first one is bending failure, another one is shear failure, and then last is deflection failure. In case of bending failure, the compression flange will be get crushed, or beam generally occurs due to the crushing of compression flange or fracture of the tension flange of the beam. So the flange is get crushed or fractured. Next is shear failure. As we all know, shear is resisted by the web. So when the web gets fail, that results into the shear failure. So this occurs due to the buckling of web of the beam near the location of high shear forces. The beam can fail locally due to the crushing or the buckling of the web near the reaction of the concentrated load. So the failure of the web is nothing but the shear failure, and excessive deflection or excessive deformation results into the deflection failure of the beam. We'll see the design steps. So the design criteria of laterally supported beam, as per the clause 8.2.1 of IS 800/2007, is the first step is the load acting on the beam are calculated by multiplying the appropriate partial safety factor. Whatever the loads will calculate that load by multiplying the appropriate partial safety factor. Then the bending moment distribution and the shear force along the beam length is determined, and from that the maximum bending moment and shear force is calculated. Basically, we get the loads here, and with the help of these loads, we'll calculate the maximum bending moment and maximum shear force. Then with the help of maximum bending moment, we'll select a trial plastic section. For that, we need plastic section modulus, and plastic section modulus is given by Zp is equal to Md divided by Fy divided by gamma m naught. Md is the maximum bending moment, Fy is the yield stress of the material, and gamma m naught is the material safety factor. Next step is, here we have determined the required section modulus. We'll select a suitable section by using the steel table or IS handbook number 1. And for the design of beams, we generally select ISMB, ISLB or ISWB sections. We will not select ISHB section. That we will use in the design of columns. Then we will classify the sections, that is whether it is a plastic section, compact section, semi-compact section or cylinder section as per the table number 2 of IS 800 2007. For that we have to see two criteria, B by TF and D by TW. Next we'll calculate the design shear strength with the help of this equation. VD is equal to FY divided by root 3 into gamma m naught into D into TW. D is the depth, TW is the thickness of web, yield strength and safety factor, partial safety factor. Then we'll take a check for high shear or low shear. Basically, if this V is less than 0.6 VD, this is not V, V will get from here. This maximum bending moment and shear force. We'll compare that V with this VD. So if V is less than 0.6 VD, we'll take low shear case. If the value of V is greater than 0.6 VD, then we'll design it as a as an high shear case. So we have taken the plastic section, then we will take various checks on that trial section. The very first one is design bending strength. For the low shear case, MD is equal to beta B ZP FY divided by gamma M naught, and this value should be less than or equal to 1.2 ZD FY upon gamma M naught for simply supported beam, and for cantilever beam we'll use this equation. ZP is the plastic section modulus, yield strength, partial safety factor, elastic section modulus. And for the high shear case, we'll use MDV is equal to MD minus beta into MD minus MFD. This value should be less than or equal to 1.2 ZE into FY divided by gamma M naught for plastic and compact section. And for the semi-compact section, we'll use MD is equal to ZE into FY divided by gamma M naught. If the value of M, which M? This will be this. Maximum bending moment, what we'll calculate. So if this M exceeds MD, then we have to increase the section size and we have to repeat the step number from step number 5. Then the design shear strength VD should be greater than the maximum factored shear force developed due to the external load. If V is greater than VD, generally if V is greater than VD, then we have to redesign the section by increasing the section size. Then we have to take a deflection check as per table 6 of IS 800 2007. Here we have taken the check of strength of beam in bending, in shear and in deflection. Now we have to take a check for web buckling. So for the low shear case, D by TW should be less than or equal to 67 into epsilon. So the web is assumed to be safe in web buckling and the shear strength of the web is governed by the plastic shear resistance. If this check gets satisfied, then it is assumed that the web is safe in web buckling. But for high shear case, if this check gets satisfied, then also we have to take a check for web buckling for the high shear case. The web should be checked for buckling in case of high shear even if this limit is satisfied. So how to take the check for buckling with the help of this formula, FWB is equal to AB into FCD. Now what is this A? A is equal to area of the web at the neutral axis of the beam. How to calculate? It is equal to B into TW. We all know TW is equal to thickness of web, but what is this B? B is equal to B1 plus N1. But now what is this B1? B1 equal to bearing length and N1 is equal to D by 2. D is the depth of the section. And this FCD. This FCD is equal to the design compressive stress, which can be found from table 9C. This table 9C can be used only when the buckling class is C. If we have some different class, then we have to use some different table. Here we have taken the check for web buckling. Now we have to take a check for web crippling. So FWC should be greater than V. This is our design shear force, what we have calculated in the beginning. FWC is equal to B1 plus N2 into TW into Fy divided by gamma M0. B1 is the same thing, but what is this N2? N2 is equal to 2.5 into R into TF. R is the radius of root, TF is the thickness of flange, TW is the thickness of web. If all these checks get satisfied, then our design is safe. Here, this is how we have to design a laterally supported beam subjected to low shear or high shear. These are some review questions. You can pause the video and answer these questions. A section is required to be designed as high shear case when the factored shear force is. And the answer for this question is more than 0.6 VD. Another question is, purlins are designed as, purlins are designed as continuous beam, simply supported beam, cantilever beam, or none of the above, or none of these. So purlins are designed as an continuous beams. These are my references. Thank you.